Hello and welcome to this expert level SelectorsHub tutorial. This is the fourth tutorial in my SelectorsHub free full course. I will explain how you can save time by using the features of the SelectorsHub tool, find locators in Selenium etc. for web elements in Shadow DOM or iFrame or both Shadow DOM and iFrame, and how to write Xpath in Selenium etc. for static SVG images and dynamic SVG images. Let me start with a simple topic in this SelectorsHub training. In SelectorsHub, it is possible to customize the user interface of the SelectorsHub Xpath tool. Let me show you how. This is the SelectorsHub practice page, and here let us say I want to inspect an element. So I can right click and click on the inspect menu option. So that is going to open the Chrome dev tools. Now here if I go to SelectorsHub, so here we can see all the selectors. This is the relative CSS selector, this is the relative XPath, index XPath, etc. Now there is a scroll bar here, and using the scroll bar you can scroll up and down, but it is possible to customize that. Now there is this icon whose tooltip says click to expand selectors block to see all generated selectors. So if I click on it, then I can see all the generated selectors like this. Another customization available in SelectorsHub is that by default it generates the selectors with single quotes. So if I click here, it copies the relative CSS selector to this editor box here, and here we can see that submit is enclosed by single quotes on both sides. But there is this icon, it says generate selectors with double quote. So if I click on it, then SelectorsHub generates all the selectors with double quotes. Now if I click here, then it is going to copy, and the value submit is within the double quotes. Now SelectorsHub has a smart editor. When you customize the UI, it saves the settings locally. You can get the same settings when you open SelectorsHub again the next time. So let me close this and open the dev tools. Control Shift I or press the F12 key. And here when I go to SelectorsHub, so it has, let me inspect this, and here we see that still we are getting the double quote and the scroll bar is gone. Now it is also possible, suppose you made some changes and you are not happy, you want to go to the default, so you can reset the UI. So that is the last icon whose tooltip says click to reset all settings to the default. So now it is in the default. Now by the way, I have installed the latest version of SelectorsHub, which is 4.5.6. I already showed how to install SelectorsHub in my previous three tutorials, so you can install the latest version of SelectorsHub if you have not already done that. Now SelectorsHub also works with different themes. For changing the theme of SelectorsHub, so we can go to dev tools, and there is this settings which is the gear icon. So click here, and in preferences the appearance is the first group, and here currently my theme is set to system preference, so I can change it. So let us say I want to change it to a light theme. Now what I need to do is I need to reopen dev tools in order for the theme to work. So I have reopened the Chrome developer tools, and now if I click on SelectorsHub, so here you can see that it is in the light theme. So let me revert it because I just want to go with the system preference, and I need to close it and reopen the developer tools here. Next, SelectorsHub Shadow DOM. As I mentioned in the second tutorial, a shadow DOM is outside the main DOM. basically a shadow DOM keeps some web elements inside it. And the shadow DOM is attached to a web element in the DOM. Now only CSS selectors work for shadow DOM, not Xpath. So let me show you. I'm back on the SelectorsHub practice page. Now if I scroll a little bit down, there is this username and there is an enter name for the username field. So right click and click on inspect, and that is going to open developer tools. And I have dragged SelectorsHub to be the first tab here. Now here in SelectorsHub, first of all, it says this is inside shadow DOM. Now this input web element, and we can go a little bit up and see that it's in the shadow DOM, where the web element says hash shadow hyphen root, and this is a open shadow DOM. Shadow DOM can be open or closed. So SelectorsHub mentions that, and it also gives an alert here. This element is inside shadow DOM, which can't be accessed through Xpath. So use CSS selector. And here we can see in relative Xpath, it is not mentioned because this element is inside shadow DOM, but the relative CSS selector is there. So I can copy it to the editor and press the enter key, and it says one element is matching. And the other thing is that SelectorsHub also shows you some sample code. So this code here, the comment is this element is inside single shadow DOM, and then relative CSS selector, and there is, in order to get the shadow DOM element, so it has to call the get shadow root method. So basically you can take this sample code and modify it for use in your test automation script. Now it is also possible that one shadow DOM is within another shadow DOM, that is called nested shadow DOM. So if I go a little bit up, now here I can see lunchtime, and there is an input field, what would you like to have. So let me inspect this one. It says this web element is inside iFrame. So there would be an iFrame here. In fact, we scroll up some way, then this is the iFrame. Now it also says that, gives the alert, this element is inside iFrame, and switch inside iFrame to access it through automation. And in relative Xpath, it mentions this element is inside shadow DOM, and for such elements Xpath won't support, so we have to use this CSS selector. And here there is some sample code also. So what I'll do is I'll copy this code and paste it in the test automation script to see how SelectorsHub generates the sample code for nested shadow DOM also. Now I have copied the code in my Selenium JavaScript in Eclipse, and here I have made a couple of changes. So the first change is, because the web element is inside iFrame, I have written driver.switch to frame and given the ID which was generated by SelectorsHub. And for that web element, I put it in a variable called lunch, and I'm going to send in some test data here, like cheese, capsicum, pizza, something. So let me run this script using the sample code generated by SelectorsHub. Now Chrome browser has started. I wrote a code line to scroll down some distance, and let us see here in lunchtime. So it has written that one. SelectorsHub also works with closed shadow DOM. So let me inspect this element here. and here it says it is in Shadow DOM and there is an alert. This element is inside Shadow DOM which can't be accessed through Xpath and so use CSS selector for it. And there is a separate tutorial that you can watch to see how to handle closed Shadow DOM element. So in that tutorial, basically you have to go above that Shadow DOM and then using the actions class you can navigate to that web element, and then so basically it is a workaround. Next, how to use SelectorsHub to work with iFrames. As I mentioned in the second tutorial, iFrames are used to make a web page layout. Now the iFrame can be from the same domain or it can be a cross origin iFrame. Cross origin iFrame meaning the iFrame is from another domain. This is my blog, Software Testing Space, and here this followers is basically a cross origin iFrame. So if I right click on one of the followers and click on inspect, SelectorsHub recognizes that this element is inside cross origin iFrame. So now it is not showing the selectors. So for an element inside cross origin iFrame, you have to copy selectors by right click on element. So right click on this and go to SelectorsHub, and let us say I want to copy the XPath, so I can click here and this is that XPath. Now I can use this XPath in my test automation script. Now I am back on the SelectorsHub practice page, and here in memory test there is current crush name. I inspected that, and here SelectorsHub is saying it's inside iFrame and it is given the frame XPath also for us to use in driver.findElement etc. command. And here in the sample code we can see that this is inside two nested frames. So SelectorsHub is giving the XPath for frame 1, XPath for frame 2 and XPath for the inspected element. So SelectorsHub even works with nested iFrames. And I already showed you that SelectorsHub works with Shadow DOM that is inside the iFrame. Next, let me show you how to find XPath in Selenium, WebDriver, etc. for SVG elements. SVG stands for Scalable Vector Graphics. It is a format for two-dimensional images and it is commonly used in the web pages. Now, SVG elements have a special XPath syntax. I'm back on the SelectorsHub practice page. SelectorsHub supports both static SVG as well as dynamic SVG. So let me inspect an SVG here. So this is the SVG, and SelectorsHub basically says it's an SVG element. And it gives the alert this is an SVG element and it doesn't support standard XPath format. So there is a special way to write the relative XPath here, and that we can use in our test automation script. SelectorsHub also supports dynamic SVG. So this is my Twitter and here you can see my tweets etc. Now how to work with dynamic SVG, that I'll just show you. So first I can customize the UI in SelectorsHub, and here there is a debugger start time. So basically if I click on the debugger icon, it is going to start after 5 seconds. But I can have the debugger start immediately by putting this as 0, and again click on the same icon, click to go back to home screen. And now here if I reload this page, so I can click on the debugger icon and here it says paused in debugger. So what I can do is, this is the dynamic SVG which appears for a very short time. I can click on the elements tab again and click on inspect, and then I can click here and SelectorsHub recognizes that this is an SVG element, and it gives the relative CSS selector and relative Xpath. One other thing, which is SH selector. So I'm on the SelectorsHub practice page, and let us say I inspect this email field here. Now in dev tools it is possible to copy the XPath or CSS selector, but SelectorsHub obviously gives you the correct and unique locator. So on dev tools I can right click and copy the XPath, and I can go to SelectorsHub and paste it here and press enter. Now here you will see that one more row has come, which is the SH selector. So SH selector, or the SelectorsHub selector, is a CSS selector from your XPath. So SelectorsHub basically can convert your XPath into CSS selector also. And in SelectorsHub, on whichever screen you are, for example this is the attribute filter, so you can click on the I button in SelectorsHub to see the relevant tutorials or more details. That's all in this SelectorsHub tutorial. You can save a lot of effort in writing your automation testing scripts with SelectorsHub. In the next tutorial, I will try to cover some SelectorsHub interview questions and answers. Thank you.